Hello all, welcome back to my channel Tasty Bites. So in this video we are going to see how to make delicious spicy peri peri poha. So we will be requiring soaked poha, and which is easily washed, a mustard seeds, carrot cut into small pieces, corn, onion, ground nuts, curry leaves, grated raw mango, lemon, oil and other spices. So in this spice bowl I have salt, peri peri, chili powder, garlic powder and other herbs which is mixed together. So now we need to be on the stove. That's the stove is on. We need to be pouring little oil into this now. So after pouring the oil in, waiting for about a few seconds, it will start to boil slightly. Then we need to be adding the mustard and the curry leaves. Now our oil is heated, so we need to be adding mustard. Yeah, after waiting for it to splutter, we need to be adding curry leaves and ground nuts. Yeah, so now it will start to splutter. I'll be adding the curry leaves into the bowl. Yeah, after adding the curry leaves, wait for about two seconds, and then add the ground nuts. And we need to also be stirring this. After stirring this, we need to be adding the ground nuts. The ground nuts we need to stir it quickly. Yeah, so after mixing the ground nuts we need to be adding the onion into this. Mix it. Yeah, so now we need to be adding the corn and carrot together into the mixture. And again mixing it neatly. This should become translucent, the onion should become translucent. Should be stirring it till then. We need to fry this until it becomes soft and tender. Now this has become almost tender. We can be adding any vegetables into this, like capsicum, mushrooms, any other vegetable of your preference. Now we need to be adding the mango, the raw mango which is grated into this. And again give it a nice mix. The fragrance of it should be coming now, it should be very good actually. Yeah, now we need to be shifting this onto the low flame. Yeah, then we need to be slowly adding the poha into this. Adding the poha, we need to add all the spices into this. After adding the spices, we need to squeeze the lemon into this. After squeezing the lemon, we need to take our spatula and give it a nice mix in low flame only. If not, it's going to get completely roasted. So now we need to keep on mixing this until the poha turns into somewhat reddish orangish color. But the flame should be on low, not too high, and it should not be off also. Like, this is optional now, so I am adding a little bit of sugar to give it a tangy chatpata taste. But we should not be adding too much, if not the spicy poha will turn into a sweet poha. We need to mix the sugar. Yeah, so now as you can see, this is kind of red in reddish orange color, and the fragrance of the peri peri and ginger garlic paste would also be coming. It would be very nice. Yeah, so after mixing this, we need to add the coriander. We need to off the stove and then add the coriander. Coriander, mix it and close it for some time. For about 2 minutes. Yeah, 2 minutes will be fine. Mix this and the flame should be off. Yeah, after mixing the coriander with this, we need to be closing the lid. 2 minutes. Now I've taken this into a serving plate, so it's very delicious. I can make out by the aroma, and you can have it with some curds or raita or anything you prefer, and enjoy.